Hi guys, this is Stephanie. Welcome to White Oak Christian Church and welcome to the Grow Zone. This month we're talking about promises and specifically God's promises. And today we are going to be talking about the fall, a very biblical term, but we'll get to that more later. So we're going to be starting off in Genesis, and you know the drill. In Genesis, we talk about the beginning of everything. Starts off even in the beginning. So we're going to go through, just to get a little background, what occurred at the very beginning in chapter 1 of Genesis. So, have this great little guide for us. So day 1, God created light day and darkness night. Day 2, he separated the waters from the sky. Day 3, he made land, sea, and the plants to go on the land. Day 4, sun and the moon. All right, this is where the drawings get bad. Day 5, birds and fish. It's a great bird, isn't it? Day 6, we have the animals, like my cute little fox there, and people. So Adam and Eve. And then on the 7th day, God rested. So let's go back to Adam and Eve. I have volunteered 2 people to help us play Adam and Eve today. So I have Ken here and Barbie here. They look nothing like the real Adam and Eve, but they're going to help us today. So, God made Adam out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And then he realized that Adam needed a companion, so he created Eve from Adam's rib. So, those two are living perfectly in this wonderful garden that we call Eden. And Eden is a beautiful, wonderful, perfect place. But God gives them instructions about eating. He says you can eat any green thing except for these two trees, the tree of life and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. So you can do anything, eat anything that's green, but you have to follow that rule. So life is great. They're living their lives, doing fun things. But God did give them free will, so they can make their own decisions. So one day, Eve is approached by a serpent. So we would normally think of this as a serpent snake, right? But in the Bible, it tells us that the serpent had arms and legs. So more like this guy, except evil. See these eyebrows? Very evil. All right. Because it's Satan clothed as a serpent. So serpent is talking to Eve, making her question God, wondering why she can't eat the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Why can't she do that? And eventually, he convinces her to eat it. So this is the first disobedient act to God. She eats it, nom nom nom, and then she gives it to Adam to also eat it. So he eats some of the fruit, nom nom nom. The first act of disobedience to God, and that's why we call it the fall. So humanity has fallen, and our relationship has been broken with God. But the big idea for this day is that God promised to fix what was broken. So, little recap here. God created the world. God created people. God created Adam and Eve specifically. Adam and Eve sinned by disobeying God, and that resulted in the fall. So now sin is in the world. So now we know man is not perfect, but we also know that God's ways are always perfect. So we can trust in him, and we can trust in his promise. And again, his promises, God promised to fix what was broken. So I hope you enjoy learning more about this series. I hope you enjoy the next video, and it has been a pleasure meeting with you guys today. I worship you.
never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Oh my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Oh my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Oh my God, that is who you are.
You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Oh my God, that is who you are.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. It's me, Carl.
And I'm Eduardo.
And welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome. I'm very excited you're here.
He said it.
Welcome to Grow TV. Introducing your host, Carl. And your co-host, Cassie. Where we learn, where we grow, and we talk about Jesus. Once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Hello, everybody. So glad you could be here. And boy, do I have a surprise for you. I want you to meet someone who is very special to me. I was walking through the park one day, and in the middle of the sidewalk, there was this beautiful egg. I was stunned. I didn't know what to do. But what I did know is that if he stayed on that sidewalk, he would get hurt. So I took him home. So I present to you, Eduardo. Say hello, Eduardo. He's shy.
What's that?
Oh, stop. They're gonna love you. He's a little shy. Don't worry, Eduardo. There's no reason to be shy.
Carl?
Hey, Cassie.
Are you feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm feeling okay. Why do you ask?
Really? I mean, you're talking to an egg.
Oh, Cass, I'm not just any old egg. This is Eduardo.
Eduardo?
Yes, ma'am. He's the cutest little egg in the world. Not only is a one in a million egg, he's a one in a dozen.
Okay. Did you give him that name?
Sure did. Thought of it myself. You like it?
Sure. It's interesting.
Well, I mean, it wasn't my first choice. You want to hear the other names I thought of?
Not really.
Great! So at first I thought of Shelly because of the chill. Then I thought that wasn't strong enough of a name. Then I thought of Yoko. Scarlett Yoke-Hamilton, Thomas Eggison, Egna, Yolanda, Lil Yoki, Edgar Allan Poe, Egg Sharon, Egg Xavier, and Greg.
Greg?
Yeah, like Gur Egg.
Nice. So what now? Are you guys like best friends now?
We are. When we found each other, just linked. Like two childhood friends who knew each other since like, well, childhood.
Not gonna lie, that's a little weird.
Cassie, you wouldn't understand. It's an egg thing.
I guess.
You should have seen me. We're playing catch just like the old days.
What old days?
Back when I used to play baseball.
You never played baseball.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Harry? Take a deep breath.
Hey, Eduardo.
Carl, it's okay.
It's not okay. Eduardo, I dropped him. I'm a terrible person.
Carl, you're not a terrible person.
Yes, I am.
No way. You're nice, you're funny, and you make videos that crack people up all the time.
I do?
Yeah.
I make people crack up all the time?
Oh, I didn't mean...
Just like how it cracked Eduardo!
Listen, Carl, I think we should talk about this week's story.
What's the point?
Well, I think it'll make you feel better.
Really?
Really. Remember the beginning of the Bible where God created the universe?
Yeah, I do remember that. That was awesome and perfect.
It was, and on the sixth day of creation, God created the first two humans ever, Adam and Eve.
And they were pretty perfect too.
They were. It was all created the way God wanted it to be. But something bad happened.
Oh no.
There was a bad snake that lied to Adam and Eve. And after God had made everything, the Bible talks about a serpent talking to Adam and Eve.
A serpent? Like a snake? Why would they talk to a snake?
It's hard to say, but the serpent was very clever. You see, snakes represented the presence of evil or chaos in the world, and that's what the serpent wanted. He wanted Adam and Eve to doubt themselves and want something else, something they knew God didn't want for them. So they listened to the serpent, which no longer made them perfect as God created them.
That's horrible. This is a sad story.
Sure was, but later in Genesis chapter 3, God made a promise.
What promise did God make?
God promised that even though people are no longer perfect, God's ways would always be, and that God could make what was broken whole again.
So God promised to fix what was broken?
Yep. And you want to know some good news?
I would love some good news.
You just said our big idea. Today's big idea is God promised to fix what was broken.
That's right. And on the count of 100, no, 3, we're all going to say it together. Ready? 1, 2, 3. God promised to fix what is broken. Woohoo! All right. Good job, everyone. Yeah.
So how are you feeling now, Carl?
Better. It hurts seeing something that I love broken, but it's cool to know that God can fix things that are broken. Plus, having an egg as a best friend can be really tough.
I guess you could say it isn't all that it's cracked up to be. See you next week, kids.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of Road TV.